You've probably heard a lot about rising sea levels and flooding like never before. But the biggest water crisis brought on by climate change could be not having enough to drink. Three of the world's biggest cities, with over 3 million people, already face extremely high water stress. That's a total of 255 million people throughout the world. But by 2030, that number could almost double. 71% of the planet is covered in water, but only 2% of that is fresh. And only half of that is actually accessible, 1%. The rest is trapped in glaciers and ice sheets. After looking at how much water is actually available, and how much is used for other resources, we are left with 0.007%, and climate change is going to take a hacksaw to this slim percentage. A warming world is speeding up our hydrological cycle. That's our water cycle. In a warmer world, more water is evaporating into the atmosphere, and warmer air can hold more water vapor. So when a storm comes along today, there's a lot more water vapor up there for that storm to sweep up and dump on us than there was 50 or 100 years ago. That's why our heavy rainfall events are increasing. But heavy rainfall is bad news for groundwater. Because in order to recharge our groundwater resources, we need the rain that falls to sink into the ground. When it falls in heavy downpours, it runs off into rivers, streams, and eventually the ocean, and we don't retain as much on land. So as climate changes, our natural pattern of variability, wet and dry, is being stretched in both directions. And that's bad news for our water. Climate change is making our droughts stronger, longer, more intense, and in some places, like California and Texas, where I live, more frequent as well. During the California drought, some farmers would spend days trucking in water to meet their basic needs for their farms. And where there's water shortages, there can be war. The 5-year Syrian drought produced crop failures that exacerbated the existing political instability and the ensuing civil war that in turn created a global refugee crisis. In Yemen, which has been slowly running out of water, towns have been going to war over water, and now the country is almost in complete collapse. Over 1 billion people depend on seasonal melt from snow and ice, but the Himalayan glaciers may lose over 40% of their ice by the end of the century, and the Alps could have 70% less snow. None of this accounts for global population growth, but water use has grown at more than twice the rate of our population increase. That means we don't just need more food, we need a lot more water. Water has to be treated as the scarce resource it is before we run out of it, not after.